Visualizing your data into charts can be a game changer for understanding trends within large amounts of data at one time. Notion has launched one of its biggest updates recently, which is the addition of charts. In this video, we wanted to do a deep dive to show you how to use charts and the best practices for it. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. The first thing we wanted to cover is how do you add charts into Notion? So to add a chart, if you already have an existing database, you can click plus and it basically appears here as a new visual for your database. So it basically creates a chart automatically and you have the chance to change it to horizontal bar, line, or donut. If you don't have an existing database, what you can do is type slash chart and then you can choose what kind of chart you want to add. Let's say we want to add a donut chart. And basically you can choose one of these databases to start with. We would recommend you to use an existing database as that's really what charts exceeds at, is to be able to visualize your data. So let's say that we include this chart here based on our task database. Then we can see how many tasks are in high priority, how many are medium, and how many are in low priority. The next thing we wanted to show you is basically how do you edit this chart. If you want to edit this chart, you'll want to go to the three dots here and then you can see all of these options. So you can either choose vertical bar, horizontal bar, line, or donut. You can also choose what to show. So in this case, we can choose between priority status or name. You can choose what each slice represents, whether that's the count and so on. And then you can do things like sort by. You can also change the color, more style options, and so on. This is where you can do all of your editing for this chart. The next thing we wanted to go over is when to use each chart type. So in this case, we're starting out with a donut. And donuts are really useful to see single properties. So in this case, we see all of our tasks and we see how many of each priority level is in each of our tasks. Another great way to use a donut chart could be to show your budget and how much is being spent on what. So in this case, you had 1,000 total. So this can be a really great visual of your total amount that you're budgeting towards different things. The next chart type we wanted to show you is the line. And lines are great when you want to show data over time. So in this case, we can show how many tasks there are each day. So if we go to here instead of priority, we're going to show the date and we're going to show the day. So then you can see that there were 5 tasks on August 14th, 6 tasks on August 15th, and so on. And what you can also do if you go to the three dots here is that you can also group it by the priority. So in this case, you can see here that there were 3 low, 2 high, 1 medium, and so on. So this is a really cool way to really see your data. And just as a reference, this is what the original database would look like. So we have our priorities, we have our dates here. The other chart we wanted to show you is a bar chart. So if we go ahead and click horizontal bar, you can see exactly, there were 1 high, 1 low, 1 medium on August 13th. However, with bar charts, we would recommend it not to be based on time, but rather additional properties. So if we go ahead and go here, and instead of what we show here, the date, we could recommend something like the priority instead. So you can see how many are in each priority. Within that priority, you can also check how many are completed. So you can show 2 kinds of properties here. So here, if we go to what to show and then group by, we can actually go ahead and change it here and then change it to status. So none of these are currently done, so it's going to show up like this. But if we start putting some in progress and some in done and then some in progress, you can start to see a better picture here. So in this way, you can see which high priority tasks are not started, in progress and done, and so on. So you can compare 2 different properties. If we go ahead and go to the three dots here, we can also show it in this kind of bar graph system as well. The next fun element about charts that we want to go over is all the ways to style it. So if we go ahead and go to the three dots, we'll show you all of the more specific ways you can style your charts. So the first thing is that, of course, we went over what to show. The other thing you can do is this sort by. So if you want to show, for example, your high priority over here, you can manually edit these as well as turn them off. The next thing we wanted to show you is that you can have omit zero values toggled on. It's toggled on right now, but if you were to turn it off, you could see that which tasks have no priority here. Then the same kinds of options exist here for group by and sort by. And then we have color. So right now it's on automatic. So that means that it's taking the status colors here as the colors here. If you want to change the color to colorful, you can do that. You can also choose any of these types as well. So we really love Notion's color schemes, and this is such a great way to visualize the data. Then we have more style options. So the more style option is quite fun as well, because you can change things like how big the chart is. You can also change the group style. So you can do stacked. If you want to show it that way, you can see percentage this way as well. You can also change the grid line. You can also choose to show the axis name like this if it gives more information. And you can even toggle on or off the legend depending on what you're looking for. And you can toggle on or off the data labels. Another really unique element about charts is that you can actually export it. So if you go to save chart as, and then you can copy it as PNG, you can download it or download SVG. And you can also change the background colors. And the final information we wanted to cover is the pricing. So currently, if you're on the free plan, you are only allowed one chart per workspace. And if you are in the paid plan, you have unlimited charts. So what this means if you're downloading a template is that you still only have access to one chart. So if you've already used up the one chart per workspace, you're not going to be able to see any charts in duplicated templates. So this is a bit different from how automations work. So some people might be surprised by this pricing plan, but it could also be a really good incentive to switch to the plus plan so that you can actually have unlimited charts. If you are on the free plan, however, if you want to simply use this feature to export the charts, that might be a great option. So you can just create your chart, export it, and then you can delete that chart and then make another one and export it and so on. So that might be one way to use charts if you want to continue staying on the free plan. However, if you want to really see your data dynamically, it could be really useful to be able to create unlimited charts. Thank you so much for watching. We'd love to know how you're finding charts so far. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to let us know, and we hope to see you all in the next video.